have Clinique expert Nita with me, and she is going to answer all your acne related questions. Now, we've got over 300 questions.
Wow.
Yeah, lots of questions. And I feel like acne is something that, you know, there's always questions about, and you don't know what's right or wrong. You're always thinking, is this the right product? Is this the right myth? Is it true? Is it not? And I went through that as a struggle personally, which a lot of you know. So I feel you when you ask these questions. We're going to get started, and you have to try and answer as many as you can.
I promise that.
Okay. So the first one is a very generic question that a lot of people have asked.
Okay.
What causes acne?
Okay, well, this is the most common question that I come across. So there are multiple reasons that can cause acne. To start with, I would like to highlight the internal cause, that is caused because of excess oil production, which clogs the pores. And the minute the pores are clogged, it cuts off the oxygen, and then which helps the bacteria to really thrive into your skin. It causes inflammation, and that leads to acne. External cause would be sun pollution, which gets into your skin. Again, it causes clogging of pores. Bacteria through hand, hair, cell phones can
generate. So basically everything.
But then of course it really takes a lot of time for one to know what is the main.
I think that's the hardest thing, finding the cause of your acne. Like, I struggled with it for 2 years. I just couldn't figure out what was happening with my skin, and I tried everything, and it drives you nuts, where you're like, what is causing this, you know?
Yeah.
So how do you get to that point? Like, how do you know what your cause is, whether it's, you know, pollution related, hormonal, not cleaning that area properly? How do you know that?
So to help you with that, Clinique is basically one stop before a dermat and one stop after a dermat. So if you know the cause, what is causing you acne, you can definitely visit us. But if you don't know the reason, you can get in touch with your dermat, and they will probably help you with that.
If it's hormonal, you have to do certain medical tests and things like that, which is what I did eventually, and figured out that, okay, this is what was happening.
We need to ask a lot of personal lifestyle related questions to get to the cause of what is the real cause of the acne.
So it's not something you would say people should do at home. Like, you do need to, I guess, see someone, consult someone to figure this out.
Of course.
Mm-hmm. And I feel like this pollution is a big thing. Like, a lot of people say my acne is pollution related, but yeah. I mean, is it really?
Of course, yes. In fact, pollution is one of the major causes that can cause acne. Pollution is like everywhere, and it is 20 times smaller than the size of a pore. So it can penetrate deeper and can cause equivalent damage to your skin, just the way the sun and the UV rays causes to your skin. And I can go on and on when I'm talking about tips for pollution. In fact,
so what are the five basic things you would say people need to do?
I think washing twice a day would
is
be
important. Yeah, that was another question we had. People ask how many times a day should you wash your face.
So excessive washing will also not
dry.
So twice a day is good enough. Avoid warm water when you're washing. Drink loads and loads of water, which will flush out your toxins from your skin. Use a sunscreen which has UVA and UVB protection.
Okay.
So UVA of course stands for aging rays, and UVB which protects you from burn.
Hygiene is a big thing. I still change my pillow covers every day. I mean, when I had acne, you know, you read all these things online now, and you don't know how many are true and how many are just things that are there. But I read somewhere that if your pillowcase is not clean, or you get it from your hair or dandruff or all of that, and I used to change my pillowcase every day, and I've been doing that since then, even though I have clear skin now, but it's become a habit.
Mm-hmm.
And I still do it. Like, is that like a thing?
I
should ask you now that I've been doing it for these years.
Because it is, you really need to be careful in terms of what's on your hair can be on your face.
Right.
So if your hair scalp is oily,
or if someone oils their hair, then you should definitely change your pillowcase.
Change the pillowcases. If you have oily scalp, then just wash it regularly. Just keep it tight back, not falling on your face. And the last one is like chill. Studies have also mentioned that stress can cause acne on the face. So just identify what is stressing you out and look for solutions.
Yeah, it's actually, I think stress is a big thing. Like, before our wedding, I had this massive pimple on my face, like 2 weeks before. And I was like, why is this happening? And then I went to the dermatologist, and she was like, everybody comes with a pimple before their wedding. It's just stress, and I'm like, no, just do something.
Yes, I do but see people coming
with exams and like. Always, so it could just be stress related, like nothing else, and stress could just cause a pimple.
Because it also causes hormonal changes in your body.
So the stress makes you freak out, and the freak out makes you get acne. Now, a lot of people have been asking about oily skin and acne because that is a bad combination.
So at clinic, what we recommend is to go in for 3 steps basically, which comprises of face wash, which is a mild cleanser. Second step is clarifying lotion, which will sweep away your excess dead cells and clear up your pores so that you can apply a moisturizer. And one important thing that people miss when they have oily skin is they skip their moisturizer.
Right. Or sunscreen. That was another question. A lot of people said with oily skin, I've tried a lot of sunscreens and it just don't work. So I felt that too. When I had acne, honestly, I skipped sunblock for like those years. Skin. I know with drier skin it's easier, but like with oily skin, what products would you recommend?
So firstly, any face wash that you opt for should not dry your skin. It should leave your skin comfortable. Second step, when you start using clarifying lotion, is what we call as a difference maker at clinic. It will prepare your skin to absorb moisturizer. And oily skin also can be dehydrated.
Yeah.
What happens in this case is when you don't push water from outside to your skin, the oil glands get really violent and start producing excess oil, which is also the reason that you have excess oil, because you're not hydrating your skin. So it's like
a vicious cycle of like oil leading to more oil.
But and also nowadays so many lighter textures products are available, so you can custom fit the range and requirement.
And I think the biggest myth is that people think people with oily skin don't need products. Like a lot of people say, oh, I have oily skin, I don't use moisturizer. That's not cool. You have to use products.
Totally.
But I think getting the right product is a big thing.
That's right.
Claudia's secret, and lots of people have asked, what do we do with the random acne or blemishes that appear? You know, like I said, before the wedding, I had this big blob and I was like, no, or like you've got exams and you know, then the next day you have a party to go to and you've got a bit of a spot. What would you do for that?
So we have one little magic product at clinic that is called Anti-Blemish Solution.
Oh yeah, that's the spot clearing. Yeah, that's really good.
I think that product works like a miracle. In fact, I have experienced, I've left it overnight. I applied
it.
Totally shrinks it the next morning, but we have clinically claim on that. In 3 days, you'll see 37%.
I think it works really well. I've actually used that on my back as well. And the next question, there are lots of questions about acne and people getting acne on their back.
That's right.
And I remember when I had like a huge spot, I just used the spot treatment on my back and it kind of shrunk it drastically overnight. So it doesn't just work on the face, it works on the back as well. But for, again, acne, what would you say is the main cause or cure? Because a lot of people have again said they don't have acne on their face, but they've got it on their back. So what do we do for that?
I think in your earlier question, I did mention
that your hair is going to go
on your face and the back.
Yeah.
So oily scalp, dandruff, all these things will lead to acne as well. I think in this cases they need to really opt for mild shampoo and conditioner, and then probably they can keep your hair tied up so that to avoid or wear something that really
covers that. Dandruff does cause it.
It does.
Or a lot of the other people say you take medication, it stops while you're on the medication, you stop the medication and boom. So what is the solution? Because I feel like that is something you really struggle with, and I saw a lot of the questions where people said, you know, for years this has been happening to me, and then it becomes that phase where you take the medication, you go off the medication, you take the medication again, get off it. So is there a permanent solution to this? Like,
I think in this case, firstly, identifying again the root cause of the acne is important. Second thing, what you need to do is visit a dermat, get your test done to know if it is hormonal or is it like due to any of the factors,
external
factors. Avoid eating processed food.
Fried food
and everything,
sugar.
So that will help you at least prevent, but the existing ones, you need to know why it has happened. So dermat would really help.
And also I think it's a process, right? Like people think nothing is overnight with acne.
Yeah.
It is a process. Like for me, even though it took me a while to discover it, once I discovered it, it took me a while to get rid of it, to maintain it. It's like you have to religiously follow a routine and a regime for a long time. For your skin to bounce back.
So whether you have acne or you don't have acne, it's important to maintain your skin.
That obviously. Okay, now we have like a zillion questions about scars. Like everybody wants a solution to acne scars. Sadly, I get a lot of questions about scars as well. I was lucky to not get scarring. Like, yes. I mean, I had like just surface scarring, nothing that was like, you know, deep, so it kind of vanished over time. From my experience, there is no miracle cream that can get rid of scarring.
You need intense exfoliation for that.
So what would you recommend if someone is struggling with scarring? I mean, obviously there's different levels of scarring. Like for me, if I have a pimple and then I have that residue for like 3 weeks, that is scarring. For someone, they're like, I've cured my acne, but my scars are still here. What do I do? That's also scarring.
Right. See, the scarring level will differ for you
each person,
versus for me. To the extent where it is minimal, can be taken care by the products.
Like application.
Yes, by application. Yeah. But if you think it is really severe, then again, a dermatologist will definitely help. But then you have to undergo medical treatment.
Yeah, again, it's a long run process. There's no easy route to
easy route for that.
Solving that.
Unfortunately, no for this case.
The next question that we have, or actually set of questions, is about blackheads and whiteheads. Blackheads on my nose, I've had them for years.
Right.
And yeah, of course, you do those, you know, peels and all of that to pull them out and scrub and everything.
Yeah.
But long term, is there a solution for it?
See, firstly, understand why do you get these blackheads under the skin. After your pores are clogged and as I have mentioned that there is no oxygen supply, your skin gets to get oxidized.
Right.
Because of that, on the surface layer, you see blackheads.
Right.
I think the clarifying lotion is something that will really help you sweep away the excess oil. It will give the passage for the skin to breathe. It's more like a prevention before you treat that. So if you start using it, we'll start preventing it. And after 28 days, when you have a cell turnover, you'll see a drastic change on your skin.
What is a cell turnover? I've never heard that term.
Okay, so you must have noticed sometimes the skin looks nice and fresh.
Sometimes you're like, you're glowing. Sometimes you're like, you look sick.
So there are cells deeper than your layer which travels up on the skin surface, forms a dead layer, and then after 28 days, it sweeps away and you get different new cells.
Okay.
So that's where any
When the fresh cells come out is when we look our best. So that's a 28-day cycle.
But if your cells from within are damaged, the appearance will be damaged. Right. That's why
or get trapped under my blackheads. Yes. And like, we can't come out.
So that's the reason whenever you want to use any products, give 28 days, like exactly
approximately.
Oh, really? You see the results. It works within your skin.
Oh, and then so try everything for 20 days. So like a month, I guess.
Exactly.
And that's where you really tell if it's working.
Exactly, because nothing that you already have on skin layer except for dead cells that will be swept away with the face wash and clarifying lotion. But if you want to really have that clear, radiant, glowing skin, give 28 days, allow 28 days for the products to work.
Okay, She Is Jet Black asked, is putting concealer on acne safe? Now, a lot of people think when you have acne, you shouldn't use makeup. Is that really true? Or also, if you are someone who's suffering from acne, what kind of products should they look for, or ingredients in products?
First thing, when you look in for any makeup product, opt for something which doesn't clog your pores, that is non-acnogenic, not comedogenic.
And make sure it comes off.
Yes.
That is number one.
Invest in a good makeup remover.
Put it on top, but then make sure you take it off properly.
If your skin is highly sensitive, opt for something which doesn't have fragrance in the product. Use makeup products which has skincare properties. That will really help you
soothe your skin as well as
So ingredients like aloe, caffeine is non-irritating, salicylic acid will help you exfoliate your cells
like
as well.
Like you're talking Greek and Latin to me right now. I'm just like,
Yeah, but then always when you
but read the label, you know, it's something we don't do, but it's so true. Like we don't think about it and we just use stuff because you see an ad or someone says, you know, use it and you're like, okay, I'll try it. But we don't really read what's good for us and what we really need.
Right.
Like, I remember when I had acne, a lot of people used to randomly say use benzoyl peroxide, ointment. And it's a medicated cream that, you know, I wouldn't advise anyone to use that. It's strong, it's
hard. And available OTC.
And like, I just used to use it without even knowing what I'm putting on my face. Yeah. Like, I didn't even think. Seek professional advice. And the other thing, try and distract people from the acne. Focus on an area where I didn't have acne. So like, you know, do a brighter lip you know, you do your eyes up you kind of take focus away from the pimple. So whenever, like, if I had a pimple on my forehead, I used to like suddenly have this cool little bang hairstyle going. Or, you know, when you have like a spot somewhere else, like here maybe,
yeah.
You put on a red lipstick and most people are looking at your lips. They're not really looking at that. Okay, now the last question is interesting. Pixels per second asks, is there any way to make Clinique products less expensive and more accessible to everyone? Sadly, none of us have control over the pricing. But we do have an offer for you guys. We have a coupon code from Nykaa. It will be in the description so you can buy your Clinique products. And we've been reading all your comments and discussing how we want to try and help more of you and not just answer your questions. So we're going to pick three lucky winners. Comment below with your acne story and why you want to consult with Clinique, and you can get products or consult, and hopefully that will help you cure your acne.
So if you have any more questions, you can drop in into the comment section and we'll try and answer everything as soon as possible.
So yeah, if we've not answered any of your questions, comment with them. She will answer them. And yeah, I hope this has helped them because it's helped me. I've learned a lot of new stuff today. Thank you so much. And if you like the video, give it a thumbs up, enter the giveaway, and comment with your questions. See you guys.
See you.
Bye. Bye.